1974 is a significant turning point in the history of the Ahmadiyya sect of Islam. It was then that a democratically elected leader of the Islamic Republic of Pakistan declared Ahmadis non-Muslims. It was an event of its own kind in history. History of not only Pakistan, but history of the world at large. The anti-Ahmadiyya agitation of 1953 and the decision of the National Assembly in 1974 left Ahmadis prone to general hatred from the society. Once the Constitution of Pakistan declared Ahmadis non-Muslims, its opponents turned even more violent and aggressive. This made the persecution of Ahmadis in Pakistan an example of state-owned persecution. This is the vicious circle that gave way to the Anti-Ahmadiyya Laws and the Anti-Ahmadiyya Ordinance 20 of 1984.
In the history of Pakistan, the 26th of April 1984 will always be remembered, not as a day when something good was done, but as a day on which an ordinance against the Ahmadiyya Muslim community was passed and promulgated, declaring them outside the fold of Islam and making it a crime for the Muslims, Ahmadi Muslims, to declare themselves to be Muslims, to practice it, to preach it, or act upon it, or to pose in any way to be a Muslim. That was declared as a crime in Pakistan.
General Zia-ul-Haq Sahab ne 1984 mein Jamaat-e-Ahmadiyya ke khilaf April ke mahine mein ek ordinance kiya jisme hamari jamaat ki kai cheezon pe azadiyon pe kadgan lagayi, kai tak kaam karne pe kadgan lagayi ki ye kaam nahi kar sakte, aur saath hi ye bhi kaha ki hum ye islahat istemal nahi kar sakte, aur iski saza bhi rakhi jo ki 3 saal aur jurmana aur ya dono mila ke hai.
It is such a ridiculous ordinance that under this ordinance, an Ahmadi who says himself a Muslim, who do any act which the other Muslim do, he can be penalized. So this is absolutely a ridiculous act. We were not, 100% sure that this proclamation will be done, but unfortunately this ordinance was promulgated, and when it was promulgated, it was difficult for the head of the Ahmadiyya community to remain in Pakistan and to convey his message to Pakistan, because under that act, if one pray, one says salat in the way other Muslim says, so it's a crime. If say one say Friday sermon, and if use Islamic terminology, it is a crime. So that was the difficulties under which all Ahmadis, they were difficult for them to perform their duties for their religious duties as described under the Sharia law. But the Khalifa, who is the head of the organization, who has to convey his instructions and directions throughout the world, he could not convey his message even to Pakistan.
So, jo qawaneen bane the, uski rooh se, to Khalifa waqt to kuja, ek aam Ahmadi bhi apne aap ko Musalman nahi keh sakta. Isliye zara si baat se Islam zahir ho, to mukadma ban jata tha. और कई उसके बाद बड़े मुकदमे बने, ये वजह हुई थी। तो चूँकि खलीफा वक्त ने तो जमात को काम सादर करने हैं, हिकमत अमली से जमात को चलाना है, तो उस सूरत में अगर खलीफा वक्त के काम पर पाबंदी हो तो फिर तो इस मुल्क पे रहने की कोई गुंजाइश नहीं रहती।
The leader of the time, Hazrat Mirza Tahir Ahmad, on whom be mercy, could not function as a Khalifa in Pakistan. This test was yet to get tougher when a young lift attendant was to disappear.
It's about Asraf Qureshi, you see, it was a conspiracy which was prepared by the Mullahs in conjunction with the government of that period. Zia and his minister, they knew where Asrup Qureshi was. There was one day, he was not a Maulana, he was a criminal man. He was a lift operator in Islamabad, Pakistan Secretariat. And he attacked Hazrat Sahibzada Mirza Muzaffar Ahmad Sahib in the lift with a weapon. And he tried to, I mean, it was with the intention of murder him. Mirza Ahmad Sahib was active Governor General at that time. So he was basically a criminal. And he was involved in some other criminal activities also. But he went to Sialkot in a village. He became a mullah. And I mean, to create some problems for the Ahmadis, he disappeared himself. And some of the mullah, they knew where he has gone. Sometime he was in Pakistan and then he left for Iran. And here the government of Pakistan, including their ministers also, the military dictatorship also, they made a propaganda that this Maulana, suddenly this criminal became a Maulana. And they said this Maulana Asrup Qureshi was abducted from Ahmadis and he was murdered under the orders of Hazrat Mirza Tahir Ahmad Sahib. It was so heavily propagated in Pakistan, in the media, as well as the mullah, they took up this question. But one of the mullah, he said that if Mirza Tahir Ahmad Sahib is not the murderer of this Mullah Qureshi, he has been murdered by him under his orders. If this allegation is incorrect, then please hang me. And this statement was published in the press. Then suddenly, after a few times, due to these allegations, the attacks were made on the Ahmadis. The properties of the Ahmadis, they were attacked. And this was the Ahmadis' life has been visible in this, especially the Sialkot area.
True followers of a true religion face tests of many types. One such test can be migration. The only way left for the supreme head of the Ahmadiyya Muslim community to be able to lead the community was to migrate from Pakistan. This was not a simple decision. To migrate from a well-established headquarter and still run the normal course of functioning was something that could only be possible with divine help.
The religious communities, they always go through various situations and various phases of their life. One of them is that on occasions they have to go through this period of migration, leaving their place, moving to somewhere else. The head of the community or the leader or the prophet or the caliph, they have to move from place to place. So this is a phenomena which we always see with the religious communities. If we look at the example of Hadrat Nuh alayhi salam, Hadrat Nuh, he also had to migrate. Similarly, we see the migration in the period of Hadrat Ibrahim, Hadrat Ismail alayhi salam. Then we also see during the period of Hadrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Then we coming closer to the period of Islam, we look at the very famous migration of Hadrat Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. He was in Arabia, he was in Palestine, in that area, in the Middle East. Then from there, when his enemies put him onto the cross, he survived the death on the cross, and in order to fulfill his mission, he then decided to move towards the eastern country. It's a long story, but the gist of that is that he had to migrate from his home place in order to fulfill the mission, which he did later on. And also, coming further on to the noblest example of the migration, that is of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was thrown away from Mecca after very long persecution. Then God Almighty blessed him with so many victories after victories. And finally, also the great blessing was given to him that he was able to return to Mecca, his birthplace, very peacefully, victorious. And he was really made in full charge of the day when he entered into Mecca victorious. So this is the long history of the religions that we see. And also we see in the history of Ahmadiyyat that Ahmadiyyat was founded in Qadian by Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam.